Good afternoon, everyone. It's your English class, and today we are going to study our third chapter, verbs expressing the past. So we were on the page number 24. So please open the page number 24. Past perfect tense. We need to start from here. Past perfect form. Okay. So, dear students, in our last class we studied about simple past. Firstly, we understood what are the formations of simple past. So formation is this like when sentence is affirmative, we need to use first of all subject, then second form of main verb. If sentence is negative, then subject, then did we have to, as auxiliary verb we have to fill here, did. And after did, we need to use root form, subject, did, not, plus root form. If sentence interrogative, first of all we have to use did, then subject, then root form. Okay, so simple past tense we use when we talk about past. Something happened in the past, for those actions we should use simple past tense. Like if I say I met him, I went there, I played the cricket. So I'm talking about the past. Okay. Then we understood about past continuous tense. So past continuous tense we use when something was happening in the past. When something was happening in the past. So for that sense, we should use past continuous tense. Like I was playing cricket, I was completing my homework, she was completing her homework. Okay. So in this, first of all, we need to use subject, means he, she, it, we, you, they. After that, we need to use auxiliary verb, which are was and were. Then after that, we need to use ing form of the main verb. Right? Was and were, so with the first person singular and third person singular, means with I, he, she, it, and any one name, we need to use was, and with the rest of subject, we should use were. Then we understood about present perfect tense. Present perfect tense we use when something has happened just now, or something happened in the past, but it has the result in present too. In that sense, in that case, we need to use present perfect tense. So formation of this tense is a subject, auxiliary verb has or have, then third form. Okay. Has and have, between has or have, we need to use has with third person singular, and with the rest of subject, we should use have auxiliary verb. Right. So now we have come on the past perfect tense. So please come on the page number 24, past perfect tense. This we are going to understand. So first of all, formation, subject, I, we, you, he, she, it, they, name or names, then had, then if sentence is negative, we need to use had not, then third form. Okay. And in short form, we say that hadn't. If sentence is interrogative, means if sentence is question sentence. So first of all, we need to use auxiliary verb, then subject, then third form. Now let's understand when to use this tense. The past perfect tense is used to express an action completed before a given moment in the past. So when something happened in the past, basically in the past of past, when something happened in the past of past, for that case, for that sense, we should use past perfect tense. In simple words, we can say that when something happened in the past and we want to convey another action which happened in the past or past, for that sense, we should use past perfect tense. See, some examples are written here. The message came after he had left the office. So two action happened in the past. The message came. So a coming of message happened in the past and he had left, means leaving of him happened in the past. But firstly, like he had left, first of all, this action happened. After that, this action message means coming of message action happened. So which happened in the past or past, we should use in the past perfect tense. Which happened in the past, we should use simple past tense. The message came after he had left the office, means he left the office first, then message came. So this action happened in the past or past. He left the office, the message came and time of speaking. Suppose this is a timeline. S means time of speaking. So now you are saying the that saying time means like present time, and the message came in past, and he left the office. That's also happened in the past. But thing is that this message came, this happening happened in the past, and this happening happened in the past of past. That's why for this we need to use past perfect tense, and for this we need to use simple past. You can see simple past we have used and past perfect we have used here. The security forces had reached the airport before the plane landed. Means landing and reaching, both the action happened in the past, but firstly reaching happened, then landing happened. Okay, so for this we need to make past perfect tense, because this happened in the past of past and this happened in the past. It is used with such verbs as hope, expect, think, mean, suppose, won't, etc., to suggest that as expected past action did not take place. So whenever we use these like verbs in the past tense, so with these verbs we should use past perfect tense, because sense come with the past perfect tense. Like, because if we use these verbs, basically we talk about the past of past. That's why we should use these verbs in past perfect tense. Like, we had hoped means hoping action happened in the past of past. We had hoped the most of the guests would come, but they did not. I had thought of inviting at least my close friends, but I didn't. Okay. Now, dear students, on the behalf of this understanding, you need to do the next exercise. Exercise number 8, rewrite the following passage using the simple past or the past perfect tense of the verbs given in the brackets. So these verbs are given in the brackets. So you need to see that which verb is suitable, which verb will come here. Right. So you need to do this by yourself. You need to observe that, like, we need to use simple past tense or past perfect tense. Since I have told you. Come on, the 9th exercise. Rewrite the following passage using the simple past and past perfect tense of the verb given in the brackets. Simple past and past perfect tense you have to use, same you have to do. Okay, verbs are given in the brackets. Now please come present perfect continuous tense. So let's understand when to use present perfect continuous tense and how to use present perfect continuous tense. So formation, first of all, as usual, we need to use subject. Subject can be I, we, you, they, he, she, it. After that, has or have we need to mention. Either has or have. After that, been plus fourth form of ing, means ing form. Means subject, has or have, been plus ing form, then rest of things. Okay. If our sentence is negative, then we have to use not after has or have. Okay. If our sentence is interrogative, means we are making question. So in that case, we should use has or have before the subject. Firstly, has or have will come, then subject, then been plus ing form. Present perfect continuous tense uses. The present perfect continuous tense is used to express an action that began in the past and has been in the progress till the time of speaking. I have been waiting for the bus since 7 o'clock. I started waiting at 7 o'clock and still I'm waiting. So dear students, you need to understand, you need to use this tense when something started in the past and the time of speaking that is going on. And duration you have completed or any point of time is given there and you have been doing that work since that time, and for that sense you should use present perfect continuous tense. Like, I have been waiting for the bus since 7 o'clock. So process of waiting is going on, and I have been waiting from 7 o'clock and still I'm waiting. My work is not completed. Waiting action is in the process. So for that sense, we should use present perfect continuous tense, right? Again, understand, when any action is going on from a particular time, so for those actions, we should use present perfect continuous tense. Okay, suppose I can say that I have been teaching you for last 10 minutes, right? So action is in going on, but I am giving the duration also from this, you know, like time I have been teaching you. Okay, for such type of sense, we should use present perfect continuous tense. Come on the next page. I started waiting. I am still waiting. Same thing I have told you. It has been raining for 15 minutes. Means raining is still going on. And for last 15 minutes, it has been raining. It started raining 15 minutes ago and it is still raining. It is also used to express an action that finished just a short while ago. So which action finished just a short while ago for those? Sloane has been watching TV. She has stopped watching now. Means Sloane has been watching TV from a particular time, but now she has stopped watching. So for those actions, for those senses, we can use this tense too. Some stray cattle have been treading over these flower beds. They have now gone away. Since and for, since 7 o'clock, since 2013, since childhood, for an hour, for a long time, for ages. Since is used to suggest the point of time at which an action started. Mr. Menon has been talking to some guests since 7 a.m. Started talking. For is used to suggest the period of time for which an action has been going on. Mr. Mellon has been talking to some guests for 2 hours. Right? 2 hours talking has been going on since suggest the time at which an action started, for suggest the duration of which an action has been in progress. So dear students, now we have to understand for the time in the continuous tense, means perfect continuous tense, we should use two preposition. One is since and second is for. So suppose I say that main 10 minutes se padha raha hu, so I need to say that I have been teaching for 10 minutes. If I say that main 12 baje se padha raha hu, I have been teaching since 12 o'clock. So we need to use these two preposition. So now we have to understand when to use since and when to use for. So when we talk about particular time, for that we should use since. If I say since 12 o'clock, so 12 o'clock is particular time. But if I say duration, if I say for 10 minutes, 10 minutes is duration. If I say 2 years, that is duration. If I say since 2001, it's a point of time. If I say last 3 months, if I say 3 months, that is a duration. If I say since January, that's a point of time. Right? If I say for 2 days, that's the duration. If I say since Monday, that's a point of time. So when we talk about the point of time, in that case, we should use since. But when we talk about duration of time, in that case, we should use for. Right? So dear students, on the behalf of this understanding, you have to fill the exercise number 10 too. So fill in the blanks with since or for oral discussion first. Okay, first of all, you need to, means like you have to discuss, then you have to fill either since or for. Okay, and soon I'll send the answer key, then you can match the answers. Exercise 11, fill in the blanks in the following sentences with the present perfect continuous tense of the verb given in the brackets. So in the brackets, present verbs are given there. So present perfect continuous verb you have to fill. Okay, I've told you. First of all, means subject will come, then has, have, either has or have, then been, then fourth form of verb, means ing form. Come on, the exercise number 12. For each situation, ask question using the given clue for oral practice. The father tells you he is saving money to purchase a new car. You ask how long have saved money, how long money saved. So these students, some hints are there. You need to make question after using the present perfect continuous tense. Like how long have you been saving money? So some hints are there. How long save money? So you can say how long have you been saving money, or how much money saved? How much money have you saved so far? You come back home, you find a friend waiting. You ask how long wait. You need to say that How long have you been waiting for me? Okay, so in this way, you need to do this exercise. Now let's talk about present continuous and present perfect continuous tense. Comparison, I am working, I have been working. Don't disturb me, I am working. I am tired, I have been working for quite some time. So dear students, if I say I am teaching or I have been teaching, so what is this different? What are the differences between these two sentences? So basically, when I say that I am working or I am teaching, so in this I want to show the action. I'm doing this action. Okay, if I say that I have been working or I have been teaching, it means I want to show the time. Means from like this time I have been teaching. Okay. See that. Emphasize on the fact that I am working, emphasize on the activity. So in this we emphasize on activity. Emphasize on the fact that I have been working for quite some time. Emphasize on the duration. So in this we emphasize on duration. In this we emphasize on the activity. We can't see him now. He is sleeping. Emphasizing on the suggestion that the activity is in the progress of the time of speaking. He hasn't done anything. He has been sleeping. Emphasizing on the duration on the way or for which the activity has been in progress. So in this we emphasize in the activity. In this we emphasize in the time. Fill in the blanks with the correct tense. Present continuous and present perfect. Continuous or verb given in the brackets. So dear students, in this exercise, either we have to use present continuous tense or present perfect continuous tense. You need to see that and observe that and fill the either present perfect or present continuous tense. Present perfect continuous. Okay. Come on the end point. Past perfect continuous form. Now, dear students, we have to understand when to use past perfect continuous tense and what are the formations of past perfect continuous. So, first of all, subject we have to mention, then had, then been plus ing form. Okay. Just we have to use had instead of has or have in this tense. Past perfect continuous use. This tense is used to express an action which began before a definite moment in the past, had continued up to that moment and was still progressed at the time at that moment or had recently finished. Then something had been happening in the past. For those actions, we should use past perfect continuous tense, like he had been sleeping for 2 hours when I reached his house. So I am talking about the past, and when I reached his house, so he had been sleeping for last 2 hours. So here we have used past perfect continuous tense, right? The worried parents had been consulting specialist for at least 2 months. Same thing, we are talking about the past, means an action was going on from a particular time in the past. For those sense, we should use past perfect continuous tense. Okay. Rewrite the following sentence in the past perfect continuous tense using the time expression given in the brackets. So time expression words you have to use, and you have to rewrite these tenses in the past perfect continuous tense. Okay. Next, used to form. Positive statement. Used to we also use for the past habit, like he used to live here, he used not to live here, he never used to live here, did he used to live here. So when we talk about the past habits, for those sense we can use used to, like he used to take tea a lot, he used to play cricket. Okay. However, this form is not preferred now. It is more common to make a statement followed by a question tag. He used to live here, didn't he? So like dear students, when we make the interrogative sentence with used to, so we need to say that did he used to live here? But in these days we prefer to say like that, he used to live here, didn't he? I mean question tag we add. used to suggest that something was true for some period in the past but stopped being true later. Mr. Roy used to smoke. He doesn't smoke now. So same past habit we need to define. Exercise 15. This is what Tanu said about herself 5 years ago. I go to cinema a lot. I attend a lot of parties. I am late riser. So Tanu was a girl and like she said about herself before 5 years, 5 years ago. Now second exercise means be part of this exercise. And this is what Tanu says about herself. But now thoughts of Tanu have been changed. So now she's saying that I hardly go to a party. I read children's books. I avoid sugar. So she's saying like that. So our exercise is that take sentence from A and ask table sentence from B and write sentences like this. So these were her past habit sentences and sentences means activities. And these are her present activities. So you need to use past activities and present activities. And you need to write the sentences like in this way. I used to work as a typist, but now I am a nursery teacher. Right? So you can say, I used to go to cinema a lot, but now I read children's books. Okay, so this sentence you need to make with used to, and these sentences you need to make with the simple present tense. So now this chapter has been completed. So now if you want to ask any question regarding today's class, then please